Dr. Jesús Guillera from Zaragoza, Spain, gave a memorial lecture on my good friend Gert Almkvist about when one of Popeye's Bell and Calabi-Yau meet. Everybody is welcome to join us for dinner after the talk, but please let me know if you can come right after. Thank you, Lucas.
That I have chosen is from one over the square pie and Calabi-Yau meat, and it's dedicated to the memory of Gert Almkvist, a mathematical friend, Gert. I have divided the talk in three parts. In the first part, it's about Ramanujan-like formulas for one over square pie. This is a family of formulas that I discovered in the years 2002-2003. Then in the second part, I will talk about Calabi-Yau operators. These operators were introduced by Gert and Patin, Patin Sudilin and Gert Almkvist in 2004. And the third part of the talk explains the detail because in this part, we connect part one and part two. First part, Ramanujan-like formulas for 1 over square pi. Okay. In this part, I explain a family of formulas that I discovered for 1 over square pi. Apparently, they are similar to the family of Ramanujan type series for 1 over pi. This is the reason of the main Ramanujan-like formulas. The Ramanujan formulas were for 1 over pi. So, this is only apparently similar because there are also important differences. Well, in the years 2002-2003, I proved with the Wheels-Thielfelder method these new formulas. These formulas have a combinatorial part, a polynomial part of the K2, and a geometric part. And the result of the sum is 1 over square pi. So, for example, the coefficients of this series are 20 over 8, 8 over 8, and 1 over 8. Here I show a W-set proof of the first formula. You know that due to the presence of the free parameter k, this can be proved automatically. Well, we can prove automatically that this sum is a constant. And to get the value of the constant in this case is easy because we can take the limit as k to infinity and the limit compute with the sum. And all these limits are zero, except when n is equal to zero. So it is easy to take the limit when k is equal to zero, and we get the result of the sum.
So do we also need to sum over for k? If you have k on left side.
Sorry?
There is k on left side, but there's no k on right side.
Yeah, I think the point is
that's constant.
It's constant. That's their beauty.
Wait.
It does not depend on k.
Yeah.
Oh, for every k.
For every k, it's identically equal to the constant.
Yes, this is with the W set method, we can prove that this sum is a constant. And we determine the constant taking the limit as k to infinity. Well, inspired by this discovery, I thought that more formulas like this would exist. But it is difficult to find proofs by the W-set method. So to discover, I use the PSLQ algorithm. This algorithm allows to discover formulas, but not gives a proof of them. For example, to get a proof of this series, no, a proof, no, to discover this series, observe the interrogant, I have not proved it, to discover this evaluation, I define these numbers. And then, using the PSL algorithm, which is an algorithm for finding integral relations, I found this linear combination equal to zero with a precision of 100 digits for this value of j. And the coefficients are very small compared to the precision, so we believe that this is exactly zero. For example, for all the other values of j, these coefficients can have many, many digits. Once I write the series, then we can check more digits because we can sum. We can make directly this summation until a number. And for example, when it was 1,000, 5,000, depending on the power of the computer. So I discovered this formula. This is still unproved. Nobody has proved this formula.
That's for how many digits did you verify it?
Like, here?
Yeah, like many digits? 10,000?
In my computer, I checked it about 5,000.
Yeah.
But I am sure it's correct, the formula. But it is still waiting for a proof. Well, in the series we have seen, I saw that there is a combinatorial part, for example, a part like this. But what have in common these combinatorial parts? They satisfy similar recurrences. And if we have here, for example, 6n plus 1, 6n plus 5, because we have to all the possibilities with coprimes. 6 and 1 is coprime, 6 and 5 are coprimes. So we have similar recurrences. And in the year 2009, I observed that this expansion hold for all the examples I got, and I observed that for all the expansions I got, k and j are rational numbers. Here sigma is 1 if z is greater than 0, and sigma is minus 1, alternating series, if z is less than 0. So, observing this conjecture, I stated this conjecture. The first conjecture says that for the Ramanujan-like series 1 over square pi, that is when set A, B, C are algebraic, the values of K and J are rational. And this conjecture is even more interesting. If K is a rational number, such that J is rational too, then set A, B, C are algebraic. Set A, B, C. Set that when X is equal to 0, we have the Ramanujan series. The Ramanujan-like series for 1 over square pi. But observe that K and J are not independent. In fact, what we have here is a system of equations. This is equivalent to a system of equations because we have one equation for the independent term, one equation for the coefficient of x, another equation for the coefficient of square x, etc. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equations, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 unknowns. So given a value to one of the unknowns, we can determine all the other unknowns. And I choose to give values to k, and then determine the values of J, A, B, C, Z. The equations we have are linear in A, B, C, K, and J, but Z is not linear in Z. But we solve the system of equations numerically because we don't know how to solve the system exactly. So we solve numerically, approximations. And using that system of equation, I discovered one more series. And for the value of I proved this series. And calculated the value of K, and it was 2 over 3. In all the other series, I got an integer. And in this series, this example was the first with a K not integer, 2 over 3. Well, I simplified the system of equations and taking the value of, inspired by this 2 over 3, I took the value K, 8 over 3, and I got the 112, which is also rational. And the conjecture says, if K is a rational such that A is a rational, the conjecture says that all the other parameters are algebraic. I could not recognize the value of Z as a rational number, so I tried to identify it to try to see if it was algebraic. And I found that Z was 4 phi to the minus 3, where phi denotes the fifth power of the Bolton ratio. And I discovered this series, which is the unique irrational formula that I have found for 1 over square pi.
This is the open problem, the proof.
Yes. Yeah. These are solved numerically, yeah, and then recognize the parameters. I wrote this series using the square of 5, and then Martin Sudilin, who wrote it using phi, and it's nicer using phi, the fifth power of the golden ratio. And simplifying the system again of equations, I arrived to some formulas involving an holomorphic function T of Z and powers of this expression. And this expression appeared several times and with different exponents. One time with exponent 1, another time with exponent 2, and another time with exponent 3. And T of Z and H of Z are holomorphic forces. It was natural, because this expression appeared 3 times, it was natural to make a chain of variable. And inspired by the formulas of Ramanujan, I made this chain of variable. Then Q is equal to this. We can expand this in powers of Z, and inverting it, we have set in powers of Q. In the case of the Ramanujan series, this is a modular function. But here is something more complicated. But Gert observed the following wonderful connection with the Calabi-Yau theory. He proved that set of Q is the mirror map of a Calabi-Yau differential equation, and that the function T of Q, using that set is a function of Q, T can be written as a function of Q, he observed that T of Q was related to the Yukawa coupling. I will later explain what is the mirror map and the Yukawa coupling. Well, after that observation of Gert Almkvist, we began collaboration. And we began collaboration in 2010. And our project consisted in giving explicit formulas for K, J, A, B, C using the language, the functions, of the Calabi-Yau theory that Gert knew well. Making searches for every branch of rational values of K, trying to find all the convergent solutions, numerically, huh? And discovering similar series for 1 over square pi of non-hypergeometric type. The coefficients until now were combinatoric expressions, and the series was hypergeometric. But Gert had discovered many promising coefficients which are non-hypergeometric. But before talking about our joint way, I will give an introduction to the Calabi-Yau theory from the point of view of number theory. And this is part 2. Calabi-Yau operators. We will give an introduction to the Calabi-Yau theory from the point of view of number theory. This point of view was the one followed by Sudilin, Almkvist, Yang, etc. And the operators were introduced by Almkvist and Sudilin. Well, before defining the Calabi-Yau operators, I will explain this known example which inspired the definition. In 1991, Candelas de la Osa, Green, and Parkes studied this differential operator. And they observed that the solutions had the following properties. The fundamental solutions are of this form. And only y sub 0 is holomorphic. The other solutions involve logarithms. Other property that they observed is that the expansion of y sub 0 of q defined as the exponential of y sub 1 over y sub 0 and of the mid of the set, the mirror map, in powers of set and q have integral coefficients. Here is the definition of q, so inverting it we have the mirror map. Expanding this in a series, in a power series. Another property was that the instanton numbers n sub d, instanton numbers, when we, the Yukawa coupling is defined in this way, and we expand this in number series, these coefficients n sub d are integers. And the surprise was that when they calculated some of the first instanton numbers, they observed that this n sub d counted the rational cost of the generic kinetic threefolds. In the differential equation, the solution of the differential equations are the periods of the kinetic threefolds. And these numbers counted the number of rational curves of the greedy of a generic kinetic threefold enumerative property. This is of interest, was of interest for algebraic geometry and physics. But I don't understand very well this point of view. I follow the point of view of number theory. The explanation of why this n sub d count those cars was given later by the theory of Gromov-Witten invariance. In a very interesting paper of Gert and Vadim in 2004, a definition of Calabi-Yau operator was formulated. Essentially, the definition is like this. The Calabi-Yau operators share the properties of the kinetic, and the coefficients satisfy a spatial relation which is equivalent to this property of the solutions. And this involves the solutions y sub 0, y sub 2, and y sub 3. This property causes the second order Brodsky to satisfy a fifth order differential equation. If we this property is without this property, the Brodsky can satisfy a sixth order differential equation. But this property, with this property, just a fifth order differential equation. And what is better, the fourth and the fifth order operator determine each other. Now I want to say something about these numbers. This coefficient, this combinatorial coefficient, does not appear in my formulas for 1 over square pi. No. This does not satisfy the recurrences I have shown before. But now, we can go backwards and determine when a certain operator of order 5 comes from a Calabi-Yau operator of order 4. It's just to invert the Brodskians. And here are some examples. Differential equations of order 5 having a Calabi-Yau pullback of order 4 are known as Calabi-Yau differential equations of order 5. Here are some examples. Well, here are only two examples given by Almkvist and Thudilly. The first example corresponds to the holomorphic solution. The coefficients are these. And these coefficients are in one of in some formulas I discovered for 1 over square pi. So, the interesting point is that the formulas I discovered and the Calabi-Yau operators of order 5 are related. Well, Gert Almkvist discovered many holomorphic solutions which are not hypergeometric. I will show this later. Well, and this is part 3, our joint query. And in this part, we connect the series for 1 over square pi and the Calabi-Yau operators. Gert and I wrote 3 joint papers. This part is based on these 2. Ramanujan-like series for 1 over square pi and the string theory, published in experimental mathematics, and Ramanujan-Sato-like series, number theory and related fields. Ramanujan-Sato. Why? Ramanujan formulas are hypergeometric. And Sato discovered a Ramanujan series, Ramanujan-like series, type series for 1 over pi, no, but with non-hypergeometric. So Ramanujan-Sato include the hypergeometric series and the non-hypergeometric series. And here I say, when 1 over square pi and Calabi-Yau meet, an intriguing theory arises which seems far away from being understood, because we only could solve the equations numerically. A related and very inspirational paper was written before in 2008 by Yifan Yang and Vadim Sudilin. We define two functions, alpha of q and tau of q, which are related to the function t of q, or and the derivative of the function t of q. And remember that t of q is an holomorphic function which is related to the Lukava coupling. This was discovered by Gert Almkvist, that t of q was related to k of q. And we made this definition inspired by my conjectures and the connections found by Gert. And here is the a theorem. In the expansion I show, remember the expansion in the conjecture. Why is that? Here. In the expansion, here's K and J, A, B, C, and C. Well, and we prove that if Z of C is the convergent radius of the series, we have that K is equal, is related to the function alpha, and J is related to the function tau. And alpha sub C is the value of alpha at the radius of convergence, tau sub C is the value of tau at the radius of convergence of the series. And this is then, remember the conjecture. If K is irrational such that J is rational, then alpha and tau, then A, B, C, and C are algebraic. And we can formulate the conjecture. We formulate the conjecture saying that if K is irrational such that J is irrational, alpha is irrational and the square of tau is also irrational. This is equivalent to say that K and J are rational. Alpha is rational and the square of tau is rational. But here we have some constant that we must determine. We have to determine the value of H, we have to determine the value of alpha sub C, and the value of tau sub C. In fact, the more important constant is this H, because as I have said, we can reformulate the conjecture saying that if alpha is irrational such that the square of tau is rational, then A, B, C, and Z are algebraic. But to determine the stage, the best way we have found to determine the stage is to determine the value first, is to determine first the value of alpha sub C and tau sub C. I will explain that. We also found formulas for C, B, and A. These are longer, and this is the easier one. C is related to the function tau, and to a polynomial, which is the coefficient of the fifth power of theta in the operator. Well, at the radius of convergence, the radius of convergence is the smallest root of p of z. And we observe that at the radius of convergence, k and j are zero, because if we replace here alpha with alpha sub c, we get k zero. And if we replace here tau with tau sub c, this is zero, and as k is zero, this is also zero. And also at the radius of convergence, a, b, c are zero. So this is a very special solution. But at this special solution, we do not have a Ramanujan series, a Ramanujan-like series for 1 over square pi. But something similar, a limit case. At the radius of convergence, the limit of the series is 1 over square pi. And then, the series which is multiplying A is convergent. And as A is 0, 0 multiplied by a convergence is 0. So there is no contribution of A in this series. There is also no contribution of B because the series which is multiplying B is convergent. But the series which is multiplying C is divergent. So we have this. This tends to 0. But this is a divergent series. And using this function, this formula that we proved, we have, and we can, using the mirror map, we can write this in this way. And from this, we can determine the value of tau sub c. And once we have the value of tau sub c here, at the radius of convergence, at the radius of convergence, using the mirror map, we have the value of Q. If we have the value of Z, we have the value of Q. So replacing here the value of Q, and replacing here in this one, replacing the value of Q. And replacing the value of tau sub c, we get the value of alpha sub c. At q sub c, we know this, tau sub c, and we get alpha sub c. And then replacing here q with q sub c, and alpha with alpha sub c, we get the value of h. So we have everything that we need. We have the theorem, and we know the constants. These are invariants. In fact, for algebraic geometry, these are invariants of the manifold.
Which one?
So, in a family, depending on the coefficients, for a given coefficient, this is a constant. With other coefficients, this is another constant. These are another constants.
Wait, which thing was it that you said were invariants of a manifold?
Huh?
You said these were invariants of a manifold?
Difference? What?
I thought you said something was an invariant. Of a manifold?
Invariance of the manifold. For example, the H is really related to Euler, Euler characteristic. Yeah? And the
Wait, can
Euler,
you go back to that? Just with that previous?
Yeah. H is related to the Euler characteristic.
I've seen
the number multiplying the set of three, the upper constant, is the Euler characteristic. I think
it's
the Euler like
characteristic. The string theory paper, actually.
So. But alpha sub c and tau sub c are I believe, because we have not proved it, but I believe that tau sub c is related to something similar to what, in the case of Ramanujan series, we call the label. But here are other manifold invariants. But I'm not an expert in algebraic geometry. No. Here I describe our method. We have the theorem, we have the formula. The interesting fact is that this conjecture is the same conjecture, we have the same conjecture as before, but written in the terminology of functions of Calabi-Yau. But the functions of Calabi-Yau, T, is related to the Yukawa coupling. And we have seen that the Yukawa coupling is an important function because the written in Lambert series, they are counting something. And now we see that here, the Yukawa coupling is also important because when these functions, which depend on the Yukawa coupling, are rational at the same time, we have a Ramanujan-like series for 1 over square pi. This is, I think that is very interesting. And here is our method. We wrote a Maple program which follows this step. Determine tau sub c, alpha sub c, and h. Then let k take values in a big branch of rational values. Then we relate it is to alpha to get the value of alpha. Then we calculate the corresponding value of q, solving the equation alpha of q equal alpha sub 0. Then we calculate the value of y sub 0, and if it looks rational, then we evaluate the z sub 0, c sub 0, b sub 0, and a sub 0. And in all the cases, we have seen that when j sub 0 looks rational for a rational value of k, then we have a Ramanujan-like series. And what is a Ramanujan-like series? A coefficient, but c sub 0, b sub 0, a sub 0, and z sub 0 are algebraic. As all the values we get are approximations, the algebraic number we get remain a mystery. Here are some examples. Before giving the examples, I am going to back to the formula at the beginning. In this formula, observe that the coefficients are algebraic, because they are non-rational. The coefficient of the square of n is the algebraic number 5418 over 128 square root of 5. And this coefficient is always divided this, because we have formulas for 1 over square pi. So the coefficients are algebraic numbers. But we say that this series is rational, because the series is a sum of rational numbers, written in this way, because this is a common factor. Now we go to the examples. Right. First example, the z stick. The z stick is this differential operator. The periods of this differential operator, the solutions of this differential operator, are the periods of a Calabi-Yau manifold, which is called the z-stick fourfolds. It's of all the five. It's a differential operator of all the five. And here is the holomorphic solution. The coefficients are this. The polynomial, how we get the polynomial, which was which appear in one of the formulas, is the coefficient of the fifth power of theta. Here is 1 minus 6z and 6, 6, 6, 6, 6. Okay. Then, from the solutions, we determine the mirror map and the Yukawa coupling. In the hypergeometric cases, we are able to determine these values exactly. So, this was proof. Prove it. In this case, in hypergeometric, only for hypergeometric series. And in this example, the solutions are these three solutions, for k equal 5 over 3, for k equal 15, and for k equal 8 over 3. For these three values we get, for example here, j equal 84 point many nines, and we easily guess that j is 85, but we cannot prove it. For k 15, we recover this series. And for k equal 8 over 3, we discovered this one. And this was new. I have discovered this one with the PSLQ algorithm, but I discovered this is joined, Gert. This is joined with Gert Almkvist. And it's very nice, the solution, because the power of 10. We have, this is 6n factorial divide
and
factorial.
This is not algebraic. This is rational, right? This one is not algebraic. This is not square root here.
It's not?
No square root. This is completely rational.
Yes. Yeah. It's completely rational. This is. But in all the three solutions, we have a sum of rational numbers, but the coefficients here are irrational because we have to divide. But here is rational and this one is rational, completely rational, or 1 over square pi. And there are no, we believe there are no more solutions because we have made very exhaustive searches. We have searches, fractions, with denominators up to 60. We believe there is no rationable, we believe that there are no more solutions. This is different from the Ramanujan case, because in the Ramanujan case there is only one parameter k, but there is not j. So for every value of j, we have a Ramanujan type series for 1 over pi. But here, we need that k and j are rational at the same time, but we have only three solutions. In the non-hypergeometric coefficients, here are two examples of non-hypergeometric coefficients which are valid for Ramanujan-Sato series for 1 over square pi. And these were discovered by her. They have discovered many, many coefficients, binomial coefficients like this. And he used the Zeilberger algorithm for finding recurrences. What Gert did was to construct binomial sums, then found the recurrences, then from the recurrences he wrote the differential equations, and if they were Calabi-Yau, he wrote them in the big tables. What they call the big tables, they contribute Gert Almkvist, Christian van Enkeborg, Duco van Straten, and Madin Sudilin. They wrote the big tables. But that expressions, because sometimes they did not find the coefficients in closed form. But Gert found many, many coefficients in closed form using expressions of forms like this, binomial expression, and then checking the recurrences and checking later if they were Calabi-Yau. It was very good Gert in this task. And here is another example, and this is for the non-hypergeometric binomial sum discovered by Gert, and in this case we use our formulas to get the values of tau sub c, alpha sub c, and h, but then we identify these values as these rational numbers. But this is unproved. So there are many things are unproved. In the solutions in this case, there is something curious. We found only three convergent solutions, but all have 23 in the denominator. And again, a 23 here, and a factor 23 here, and a factor 23 here. We don't know why. But we believe this 23 is related to something similar to the level in the Ramanujan series. Another example, similar example, and again, there is a repetition of 21, 21, 21, because we found this solution and also solutions for these values. Okay? Example 4 is because I wanted to give an example of complex series, because I wanted to check it, our formulas, in the case of complex series. And Gert use a transformation he knew and transform this series that I have discovered in the year 2003, and using this transformation he translated it in this series, which is complex. And then so we could check it that our formulas were correct also for complex solutions. And finally, this is on the origin of the algebraicity. So you cover coupling, encapsulation, important arithmetic information in the standard number. But it is also very interesting that for some spatial values of Q, we have that set C, B, A are algebraic. And we know that algebraic numbers are root of polynomials, so we wonder how these polynomials appear in this theory. And the conjecture stating that for some spatial values of Q, we have that alpha and the square of tau are both rational is even more intriguing. For me, it's very intriguing, this property. And here is a recent photograph of Gert, year 2017, and he died 1 year later, in December 2018. Thank you very much.
Dr. Guillera, we'd like to answer questions personally, privately.